well. And the Wild able to get out. Niederreiter feeds it up ahead for Charlie Coyle. Coyle, nice move in front. Save by Reimer. Coyle got to the net.
A sliding save by Reimer, stopping Mikko Koivu. Granlund works his way to the middle. Drops it back to Brodin. A shot. He scores! May have been tipped by Zucker on the way. And the Wild fans in attendance here cheer as their team will play from in front.
Good screenshot there by Brodin, and it just gets redirected, I think, at the last second. Watch this shot, and look like Zucker got a blade on it. Beautiful setup there by Granlund, who bought a lot of time, and that's why Reimer waved at it, because it changed a little bit of a direction. Not a lot, but enough.
So, Jágr trio, not on the line tonight, but out there in the power play. And this is Yandle. And Marchessault, one-timer, save, rebound in front, they score! Jágr may have banged it in. Power play goal ties it.
Well, if Marchessault gets it, they should keep the puck. If it goes off of Jágr, they should also keep the puck. Yeah, it's going to be Marchessault's, and I told you the other night, you know what Marchessault stands for, very loosely? Il marche sur l'eau. He walks on water, if that is indeed his goal. And I think it is, because it went off the defenseman.
The Panther net, Huberdeau's got it now.
In negative thinking, as there is in the positive thinking. So turn those negative thoughts into positive energy.
Here's Pesek walking in all alone, and he scores! Mark Pesek from Trocheck, and the Panthers grab the lead.
How much energy is there now? How look at that? Pesek walked in, looked like Drew Doughty. Or maybe Carlson. Or maybe Burns. Is there any hesitation right there? Any at all? None. And he just blasts a wrister without any hesitation. Beautiful play, really. I love it when you hit that late coming defenseman.
I'll tell you, Huberdeau made a really strong play back in front of the Panther net against Eric Staal. You talk about a big, strong center.
Able to not let the Florida Panthers think that they're getting an edge.
Right off the draw, Reimer, a glove save on Pominville after the faceoff win. Pominville gloves it down. Mulgan deflected that.
Ball in pursuit. Staal trying to create a loose puck. He does. Got it to Niederreiter in the corner. Niederreiter back to Staal. He scores! What a give and go. Staal to Niederreiter. And then Eric Staal for the finish. And the Wild have the tying goal.
We've seen the combinations start to work here. Some great opportunities by this line, feeding each other. And this time it actually pays off. A great move here. Quick little backhander. Looked like it went off a body, but it still went into the net. As you look at Niederreiter make a quick little backhand feed.
So got it to the line. Hands off front for Pominville, and it just failed to click. Spurgeon centers. Hansel deflects. Reimer's down. The puck is loose. And they score! Pominville racing in from the point, able to flip it over the prone Panther goaltender, and the Wild are in front 3-2.
Reimer was down. Parisi had a poke at it. It did not go in, but well, Pominville followed up. You watch Pominville get it back. Looked like that puck hit Hansel. I don't know if that slash at the last second is what sent him off the ice or whether the puck hit him. But the follow-up here by Pominville puts it in the net.
Riley Smith lets it go through to Jágr. Jágr circling. Jágr fighting through the traffic, turning and shooting, and he scores! Jaromír Jágr! And we're tied again!
Let me repeat myself. You've got to continue the energy or give it to the hockey maven. Jágr. One or the other. Well, the Panthers did both. After being scored on, the review, losing your timeout, Florida Panthers' first shift, they spend it in the offensive zone, and Jager, with the puck on his stick, makes no mistake. That's his 13th.
And on that puck, Marchessault. Simple play to clear to center. Pass it on the shoot-in. Oh, loose in front, Barkov scores! Alexander Barkov found the loose change! It's 4-3! Thank you very much!
Randy, what was your comment about the cucumber sandwich? Dubnyk, yep. Dubnyk's not a bad puck handler. But maybe coming in late, and that puck just having a little sizzle going around the boards, obviously did not handle it, and Barkov gets an easy one to give the Florida Panthers a lead. Wow.
Barkov, 17th of the year, second lead of the night for the Panthers.
Broken up, and the Wild have numbers at center. Coyle into the Florida zone to the trailing Scandella on the backhand. Save, rebound, they score! Eric Staal with his second of the night, and the Wild have tied it at 4.
Well, that line has been good all night in creating, and that time it was a good hard rush up the wall. Charlie Coyle just gets it, and he's patient, looks to see where the trailer is. In this case, it's Marco Scandella, and batting it out of the air was Eric Staal. Scandella's been jumping into the play quite a bit more lately. And that time it paid off as Staal was able to tap that one into the open side.
Got the puck in behind the goal. Parisi settles it down there. Up to the point, Spurgeon. Hands it off to Brodin. His shot got through. Parisi scores! The puck trickled through Reimer, and Parisi buries it. It's 5-4 Minnesota.
Reimer did not squeeze that one, and it just dropped in behind him. Parisi, oh, he's always eager around the net there, and it landed right in the wheelhouse for him.
It's our Jimmy Johns delivery of the game.
Boy, the Wild moving the puck around so well in this period, and isolating different players, giving them a chance to get rid of the puck, and this one goes through a screen, hits him on the elbow. Zach Parisi cleans up the mess.
Ekblad plays it in behind for Smith. Back to Ekblad. Across for Yandle. Yandle to Ekblad. Fire, saved by Dubnyk. Rebound loose and cleared at the empty net and hit the post. It'll be icing against Minnesota as Zucker hit the post from about 150 feet.
Jager got flattened at the end of that play, but well, the Wild came very close to icing this one.
Here's our complete protection brought to you by WeatherTech.
Well, Devin Dubnyk had an awkward, quirky goal go in on him from deflecting off his own stick when he came in to this game in the third period. But boy, he makes some very good saves in that last sequence.
Zucker has it here for the Wild. Flips it up through neutral ice. Granlund kicks it ahead. Granlund at the empty net. He scores! And the Wild have a two-goal lead with a minute 10 to go.
This one looked a lot better. The Wild had a couple of icings. Zucker cranked one off the pipe from almost all the way down the rink. Another one deflected all the way down the ice. This one, though, they got out of the zone and just a big flip pass right into the skates of Granlund. Zucker just pitches this up in the air, and it just skates right under it and gets a nice little empty netter for Granlund.
And add Zucker and Granlund to the list of guys with 2 points tonight. The corner by Dubnyk. We're down to 10 seconds left. A centering pass. Staal gives it to Coyle. 5 seconds to go. Coyle at the empty net. He scores. And Charlie Coyle, who had gone 10 games without a point, now has a goal and a helper tonight. And the Wild have a three-goal lead at 7-4.
Oh, wow, just worked the puck out here, and Charlie Coyle sees the open cage and